Hello everyone, Dima Pobedinsky is with you. Look at what's right around me. It seems nothing, yes, but then what do all these items have in common? A smart light bulb, a wireless speaker, a mouse and a card for traveling in the subway? Perhaps nothing, too, except that they all emit radio waves of Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, LTE, NFSI, GPS, television. We are surrounded everywhere by radio waves of all stripes and sizes. They fill the streets, houses, apartments, permeate and surround our bodies. They are around each of us, everywhere and always. We do not see them and do not feel them in any way. But what if there was some way to see them? Tricky glasses or a special device? Will we then be able to contemplate the ocean of the radio wave in which it floats? Let's figure out what kind of radio waves there are, what they look like and how many of them are in your apartment. We will assemble a device that allows you to see Wi-Fi and even be able to touch radio waves. Well, in addition, we will eavesdrop on other people's conversations and almost from all over the world, so that no one will notice. Let's go. And to begin with, a little theory of what radio waves are and which of them we can somehow visualize just on a table from the physics room. This is a single block, but in fact they are different. So, radio waves, as a special case of electromagnetic waves, are vibrations of electric and magnetic fields. They have three parameters. These are speed, purity, and wavelength. The speed is the same for everyone in the air, almost the light frequency is how fast the fields fluctuate. For radio waves, this is from units to hundreds of billions of times per second. And the wavelength is the distance between the repeating regions of the wave. Well, in fact, its characteristic size. The higher the frequency, the shorter the wavelength and vice versa. Accordingly, a small antenna is sufficient for high frequencies. But the lower the purity, the larger the antenna should be. Yes, size matters here. The entire range of radio one can be divided in different ways. I propose the following partitioning as purity increases: super long, long, medium, short, ultra short, very high frequency, super high frequency and hypermega. It's awesome what a high frequency, but we don't need more details. And now briefly about some of them. Medium waves are the same mysterious AEM range on Chinese receivers, where only hissing is caught. Now I will explain why it is so difficult to catch something there. The fact is that the wavelength in this range is hundreds of meters. And if the receiver can be small, then the transmitter is just a huge tower, which is all an antenna. In addition, the efficiency of the transmitter is very low, so that complex and costly broadcasting in this range simply could not compete with FM radio from the VHF band. But there is one detail: FM radio can be received only in the line of sight at a distance of 10 kilometers. But for the average yuan, it's just seeds. The fact is that they can be reflected from the upper layers of the atmosphere and thus spread for thousands of kilometers. Distant cities on old Soviet receivers are just the same calculation for this effect. This is possible because there are a lot of ionized particles on the sphere at an altitude of 100 kilometers. So for medium waves in principle, for short and long ones, too, it's like a mirror from a conductor. The only thing that is sunny is that light reduces the number of ions, so long-range reception is possible only at night. But just imagine how romantic it is. Sit in the semi-darkness, turn the dial of the receiver and hear a transmission, for example, from Beijing. And this is a range of 6,000 kilometers. In the era of the internet, of course, few people will be surprised by this, but just think about it. Is it working? The wave rose to a height of 780 kilometers, reflected from the air and got to you directly, without intermediaries, directly from space. So if your country is disconnected from the internet, well, or some kind of zombie apocalypse happens, such radio broadcasts will be very useful. I think it's very cool. So in the description I will leave a link that can be heard on different frequencies from all over the world. But romance is romance, and in modern devices you do not need to turn the settings knob blindly. The fact is that SDR receivers, which usually look like a USB stick with an antenna connector, are tuned to all frequencies at once, and you literally see what the entire radio airwaves are filled with in the form of such a waterfall. The thing is amazing. Here are the stations of the M bands. Here is broadcasting in short waves, roll calls of radio amateurs from all over the world.
Переклички радиолюбителей со всего мира.
In the audio range, you can see all the FM stations, the conversations of air traffic controllers in the set 40, and at higher frequencies, you can even see the conversations on the walkie-talkie of the guards in the neighboring store. That's the way things are. Then what? And here is this piece of iron, and it is even more frequent. Cellular communication, Wi-Fi and other wonderful things. And, by the way, you can connect to one of 170 such receivers scattered around the world via the internet and scan the radio airwaves. You never know what secrets the list in the description will tell. Maybe even your city is. But the most interesting thing is happening at the edges of the radio wave range, where even the SDR receiver does not see anything. For example, extremely long, with a wavelength of more than 1,000 kilometers. They are used to communicate with submarines, because they can circumnavigate the globe and, unlike other radio waves on the surface, penetrate to a depth of up to 200 meters. For example, the Russian Zeus transmitter has a 60-kilometer high voltage short-circuited at both ends into the ground. That is, it turns out that the antenna is the whole planet. The efficiency, of course, is very low. 100 kilowatts of generator power is spent on 1 watt of a wave and the frequency is only 84 hertz. Therefore, the information transfer rate is very low, 3 characters in 10 minutes. But the entire surface of the planet is covered, and plus even underwater. How do you like that? Elon Musk? On the other hand, ranges are also interesting. As you have already understood, the smaller the wavelength, the worse they bend around obstacles and spread more in a straight line. This is used in radars. Most of them work at ultra-high frequencies and more. The scheme is clear. The antenna emits a wave, it is reflected back from the object, and the distance to it is calculated by the time of passage. And it turns out that this is used not only by military air traffic controllers, but also by policemen on the road. Look at this structure. This is not Star Wars footage, but a huge radar station Don 2N in the Moscow region. It shines in all 4 directions with centimeter waves and tracks not only enemy ballistic missiles within a radius of several thousand kilometers, but also satellites, space debris, and in general everything that dangles in orbit. The design of such radars may be different, but everyone is struck by the size and height. I do not advise you to go close to any of them, because it will fry like in a microwave oven. How it will be, by the way, I told you in one of my issues. Most radars have a certain special purpose, but Yandex has figured out how they can be useful to each of us. It's about weather radars. The wavelength of their radiation is selected so that it is reflected from raindrops, and it is possible to build a precipitation map online within a radius of 250 kilometers. This has long been used in aviation. When studying the climate, mushroom pickers probably calculate something, and Yandex uses this data to predict where rain or snow will start in the next few hours. The medium algorithm, which works, of course, on the basis of machine learning, predicts with an accuracy of up to 10 minutes where and when precipitation will begin. It works just fine, with an accuracy of up to 2 kilometers. You can check it yourself in Yandex Weather, in the app or on the website. But I like something else more. Take a look, this is radar coverage of the territory. But the precipitation map works almost all over Russia. How so? The fact is that satellites are connected here. We take data from them almost online, compare it with radar readings using a neural network, find it in accordance and build a precipitation map using only ProFit satellites. Everything works pretty accurately. However, do not forget that any weather for tomorrow is not information from the future, but only a forecast. There are always errors, and in order to reduce them, Yandex uses 4 more bases with footnotes and finds the average value. Well, he resorts to other tricky tricks. So if you don't want to take zones for nothing or get into traffic because of the removal of the bud, you know where to turn. But back to our main task, to see the radio waves. And let's figure it out. What are we supposed to see at all? Simply in physics textbooks? These are such ideal sinusoids. But in reality, everything is different. Alternating current. This current generates an alternating electric field around itself with such lines of force. It spreads further and, of course, does not exist in a plane, but in a volume, so it represents some kind of toroids. This electric field is variable, so it generates an alternating magnetic field, the lines of force of which are like this. Here they are where the electric field is strongest, and that's about what they look like. Radio waves are like circles on water, only in volume, and the sine wave from the textbook is only part of the whole picture. We will see something similar, but not in words, but some averaged values of fields. The fact is that the speed of light is, in principle, a large value, and at such a frequency, cameras cannot shoot at such scales. Well, a tube radio amateur will help us to assemble a device for viewing. Uncle Mitya, kindly welcome everyone with you, Uncle Mitya. Well, not exactly a tube, so probably more transistor. Well, to see the radio waves as clearly as possible, we need a more powerful source. And, accordingly, the indicator is more sensitive. It's simple. So, we will create radio waves like this walkie-talkies. It is tuned to a frequency of 400 MHz. Accordingly, the wavelength is 75 centimeters. It has 50 watts of power. No, maybe, of course, more. In the microwave, all 700. But you know, I'm friends with safety technology. Well, besides, we have enough. So, the antenna here is a simple pin. This is a monopole, half of a dipole. It creates a field around itself, as from the top of the dipole. That is, like this. Well, you've probably already been shown. And the indicator means we will do it ourselves. To do this, we need only three details. Firstly, this is the wire from which we will make a receiving antenna. Secondly, it is a high-frequency diode. Where do I have it? It passes current in only one direction and can open and close millions of times per second. Actually, not everyone is suitable. I have compiled a small list, that's exactly what will work. And thirdly, so we need an LED. I recommend using ultra bright, so you can see even the weakest field. Well, let's get started. Assemblies can be soldered together, but you can just twist the difference in principle, we will not. First we'll make an antenna. It will be half the wavelength long, that is, about 37 centimeters. It looks simple, but it's already an antenna. An electromagnetic wave passing through it creates an alternating current back and forth inside with the frequency of a radio wave. Of course. Now we make a gap in the middle and insert a diode into it. Now the current moves only in one direction and, we can say, the electrons accumulate on one side, which means. And finally, we add an LED. The main thing is to connect the opposite polarity of the diode correctly. Then the electrons accumulated on one side will flow back along it and it will begin to glow, which indicates that there is a radio wave here. Well, now let's visualize the radio waves. We take our indicator preferably by the LED, so that the garlic is high and the current does not flow down on us. Let's take a not very powerful walkie-talkie first. So, we turn on the transmission and attention. Oops, they glow. So there's a radio wave here. And here, 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 everywhere. In short, here they are, please, here they are, there they are. But, you must agree, it is not very clearly illustrated by the radio over there from the antenna. Therefore, let's do this. We will drive around the transmitting antenna with our indicator and take a photo at a high shutter speed. Here it just comes in handy that the LED shines depending on the strength of the field. It turns out this is the picture. This corresponds to how the electric field is distributed. Only it is because this indicator perceives the electrical component. Please note, I kept the indicator horizontal all the time and where the electric field lines are vertical, the diode does not glow, but the field is there. It is enough to turn the indicator vertically and everything will be visible. Well, the field is not radiated up and down from the antenna, but nothing was found there. From what else can it be seen? Radio waves? It's a bunch of everything. Mobile phone, router, microwave, smart speaker. The only thing is that there are more frequencies there. Two shooting ranges of 5 GHz, respectively, the wavelength is smaller, 12 to 5 cm. And therefore the antenna should be small. And just a knife of the LED is enough. And it turns out that our indicator turns out to be quite tiny, consisting of only two parts. It's also easy to use this one. Howl around the antenna and see the electromagnetic field. The only thing is that a few comments in a mobile phone transmitter for LTE or 3G is more powerful than for Wi-Fi, since it hits at a greater distance. Therefore, you can clearly see the waves by actively using the mobile internet. Well, for example, measuring speed. The same story is with the router. Turn on the data transmission at high speed and the field strength increases greatly near the antennas. At a long exposure, it looks like this. The microwave, it turns out, has microwave radio waves coming through a little from the cracks. They are reflected from objects that are spinning inside, so they can disappear, they can appear. but you can find a device that has an antenna hidden inside. It is enough to move the indicator around the body, and you will find the place where the radiation comes from. That's it, so you can see the radio waves. Well, not to see, but you can even say to feel. Because when you drive this device around the antenna, you really understand that here it is right here. The radio wave is like some kind of ghost, invisible and intangible, but at the same time really existing. I know there are no signs. It's just a comparison. You can try it yourself and see for yourself. Was Uncle Mitya with you at the reception? In general, it is still possible to see radio waves with certain reservations. It remains only to understand how safe it is. The entire range of radio waves has been very well studied and only one type of their effect on humans has been detected, thermal. That is, radio waves can be absorbed by us, but this only leads to heating. How much stronger? Well, for example, if my head completely absorbed all the radiation from this 50-watt walkie-talkie, it would heat up by 1 degree Celsius in 6 minutes. But at a distance of 1 meter, several percent of the radiation passes through my head. Well, it is absorbed, of course, even less, so there is no harm from this. But the sources in hundreds and thousands of watts are especially focused, it already warms decently and can be dangerous, so it's better not to joke with them. However, even if you add up all the devices that are in your house, add the radiation of the most powerful radio stations within a radius of 5,000 kilometers, and taking into account the radio waves that come to us from space, the total power will be in the region of one cotton wool, and maybe even less. Therefore, these radio waves do not have any significant effect on the body. So I advise you to relax and just drift in that ocean of radio waves that surrounds us. And that's it. See you soon. For now.